practicing non-interference. In our dealings with other life forms, practicing meditation, in setting ourselves right all the time. These are the two things, non-interference and anapanasati, breath observation. Buddha had given everything, but everybody has forgotten everything that Buddha gave. What happens to the world when you forget the Buddha's teachings? Well, that's what we are seeing. It is the duty of every Buddha to go out into the world and teach Buddhahood, teach non-interference and anapanasati. The more you practice meditation, the better human being you are. The more you are of a human being, the more satisfaction you have in your outer world. Not allowing your mind to wander into unnecessary things. Your very lifetime, you will forget once you are out of this lifetime. In what way this is important? You have already taken enough number of lifetimes, enough number of bodies. Enough number of laughable stories. Get back firmly into your humanity and to your meditation. And see the essence of transitoriness in everything around you and inside you. Everything is transitory. It comes and goes and 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 comes and goes. See the humor of it. If you are attached to something that comes, that's the problem. The universe, the creation is so very big, so very wonderful, everywhere, that you don't have to be stuck up anywhere. Being stuck up in one place, you miss the whole universe. Don't be stuck up anywhere. That is the essence of enlightenment. Your lifetime here in this body, on this planet, is transitory. Very, very transitory. We know that. My mom died, my father died, my brothers died, so everybody died. Tomorrow I will also leave, you will also leave, so what? The essence of Bhagavad Gita is that, hey Arjun, you must be a yogi. Be a yogi. do your duty in the outside world. Have your enjoyments in the outside world, but be a yogi. Tapasvi bihodiko yogi, jnani bihopi matodikaha, karmyabja shadiko yogi, tasmat yogi bhavarjan. Hey Arjun, be a yogi. You are a perfect yodha, but still you have not obtained peace of mind because you have never been a yogi. Lord Krishna went to a yogi at the age of 4 and learnt everything about meditation. He became a Yogishwara. At the age of 4, Jesus Christ became a Yogishwara at the age of 7. How about us? Next lifetime, we'll become a yogi. काल करे सो आज करे सो अभी पल में प्रलय होगा बहुरी करोगे कब मेरे प्यारे दोस्तों. उच्छ्वास निश्वास के साथ एक होकर रहेंगे ताकि हम भी योगीश्वर बने. हम क्या यूं ही आते हैं यूं ही चले जाते हैं? ना ही हम यूं ही आए हैं ना ही हम यूं ही चले जाएंगे. हम तो योगेश्वर और मानवेश्वर तो बनकर ही रहेंगे. महात्मा गांधी जी मानवेश्वर बन चुके हैं. द बेस्ट ऑफ द ह्यूमन बीइंग्स. How about us? Tapasvi bihodiko yogi, jnani bihopi matodikaha, karmyabja shadiko yogi, tasmat yogi bhavarjana. Hey Arjun, a yogi is a greater person than a tapasvi. A yogi is a greater person than a pandit. A yogi is a greater person than a person who does good works. So be a yogi. Jatasya hi dhruvo mrityuhu, dhruvam janma mrityasya, tasmat aparihariyarde, natvam shojitam arhasi. The moment you are born, that your death is certain. The moment you die, your rebirth is certain. So what are you lamenting for? You are lamenting that your wife died, your husband died. Nobody dies. There is no death. There is only change. A forever change. In space, time and situations for every soul. If you lament for anything, you are stupid. You don't know. You have not yet divinized yourself. You have not understood the spirituality. That which is born will have to die. That which dies will have to be reborn. Jatasya hi dhruvo mrityuhu, dhruvam janma mrityasya cha, tasmat aparihariyarde, natvam shochitum arhasi. If you lament for any reason, you are stupid. Every lifetime is meant to enjoy. No lifetime is meant to suffer. We suffer because of our own ignorance. We enjoy life because of our own wisdom. Being with your breath, my dear friends. Sarva dharman parityajya, mam ekam sharanam vraja, aham tva sarva papebhyo moksha ishyami mashucha. You forget all your duties outside world and go into yourself, meditation. Seek refuge of yourself. Sarva dharman parityaja. We have so many duties in the world, but you have to stop yourself from time to time and go and take refuge in your own grand self. Your grand self, your higher self, your over self will condone all your errors, mistakes of judgment and will give you liberation. Your higher self, your inner self, your over self will give you liberation. You have to seek the refuge. This is the meaning of that shloka. Sarva dharman parityaja, mam ekam sharanam raja. Mam means the higher self. Krishna represents the higher self of each and every soul. Like President of India represents the each and every Indian. He represents everybody. The higher soul, the higher self that Krishna is saying, oh, I am your inner being. You take refuge in your inner being. I am not available to your physical eyes. You seek your inner. There you will find your higher self, your inner self, your over self, of whose tentacle you are here on the outside world. Sarva dharman parityajya mam ekam sharanam raja aham tva sarva papaibhyo mokshayishyami ma shucha. Ma shucha, don't worry. Why the hell are you worrying? What is the reason thereof? Seek meditation every now and then, every day. Then you are liberated by your very travel into your inner self, to your over self, your higher self, my dear friends. This is called the Charama Shloka in Bhagavad Gita. Sarva dharman parityajya mam ekam sharanam raja aham tva sarva papebhyo moksha ishyami ma shucha. Don't worry. Do meditation. Don't do meditation, your life is full of worries. Hands into hands, fingers into fingers, closing the eyes and observing the breathing, my dear friends. Ya nisha sarva bhutanam tasyam jagrati samyami yasyam jagrati bhutani sa nisha pashyate muni. Enlightened people don't sleep. They are in meditation all the night. In the daytime, they do their duty perfectly, smilingly, giving happiness to everybody else. In the night time, we give happiness to ourselves through meditation. In the daytime, we give happiness to everybody by non-interference and by giving words of wisdom. It's a great joy for me to speak about Bhagavad Gita. Nothing gives me greater joy than that. Yo mam pashyati sarvatra sarvam cha mai pashyati tasyaham na pranashyami sachameena pranashyati. Whoever sees himself in everybody else and sees everybody else in himself, well, I am forever with him. You must see yourself in everybody else. You must see everybody else in yourself. And then, of course, I am with you. All the time. Yo mam pashyati sarvatra sarvam cha mai pashyati tasyaham na pranashyami sachameena pranashyati. You are a pure soul. Nothing can hurt your soul. Nor fire, nor weapons, not the air, not the water. Nainam chindanti shastrani, nainam dahati pavakah, na chainam kledayanti apo, na shoshayati marutah. The body is subject to fire, subject to air, subject to water, subject to weapons being killed, but you are not the body. If you think you are kidneys and kidney stones, neurons and nerve endings, my goodness, you have a great problem. You have a deadly problem. Because your body is going to die. Never ever talk about the body, all its parts. Talk only about the soul. And the body becomes stronger and stronger and stronger and stronger and stronger by itself. You don't have to touch it. We don't touch our shadows. The body is only a shadow. Where you move, the shadow moves. And you are a soul. So where the soul moves, the body moves. The soul is dirty, the body becomes dirty. The soul is diseased, the body reflects it as cancer. Body is a mirror image of the soul. You don't treat the mirror image, isn't it? You don't give injections to mirror image, right? The body is only a mirror image. When you understand that, you have understood properly. Come out of your body consciousness. Get into your soul consciousness all the time. You are not livers and lungs and pancreas, nor large intestine, nor small intestine, nor brain or medulla oblongata. Be with your breath, my dear friends. Come out of your biological consciousness. That is the essence of the teaching of Bhagavad Gita. Nobody is your husband, wife, guru, brother. We all ought to be friends of each other. Somewhere you are born, of course. The moment you become adult, you must come out of your birth situations. You must get into adulthood. That is spirituality, mature. Tetvam bhutva swarga lokam vishalam chine punye marti lokam vishanti evam trayi dharmam anuprapanna gata gatam kama kama labhante. After you enjoy the vastness of the heavens, you come back temporarily into a mortal body to perform three duties. Trayi dharmam anuprapanna. Taking care of the soul, first priority. Taking care of your humanity and taking care of your neighborhood. Trayi dharmam anuprapanna. Gata gatam kama kama labhante. We come and go, we come and go. Gata agata, gata agata, gata agata, kama akama. We come here because of a desire and we go away after fulfilling the desire. Kama akama labhante. Tetvam bhuntva swargalokam vishalam, vishalam, swargalokam vishalam. Huge heavens are there from where we have come to where we return. Get into the big picture. Don't be stuck up in the small picture of my body, my husband, my wife. That is the source of grief, source of cancer. Normal and natural and easy and soft and simple and tender and peaceful and tranquil. Breath, my dear friends. Your breath is your deliverer.